Hello, I'm Akshay Kaushal, and with me is fashion designer Prabal Gurung. Prabal, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Prabal, your journey has been truly inspirational. Your label has just completed 10 years. You know, did it come with a cost? And if at all, like, was there any setback in these 10 years for you where you actually had to think back and, okay, recollect yourself and get back to work again?
Yeah. I think, you know, the minute you decide as a creative person, you decide to pursue your creativity and turn it into a business, you know, those two things that's not supposed to meet together, art and commerce, whenever they collide, there's always going to be some kind of friction. And the friction sometimes can be detrimental, friction sometimes can be challenging, but in my particular scene and scenario, the friction led to a lot of, I would say, education, learning, unlearning. It has been the most amazing ride. It has been, it's taught me a lot. It's taught me my own resilience, and also it really taught me about what my purpose in life is. Is as a creative person, as a fashion designer, like the obvious job of mine is to make clothes, try to make the most beautiful clothes possible. But what I really figured out over the period of time was, like, I am a storyteller. That's what I am. So the storytelling, the fashion happens to be my language of choice, the medium of choice. But through that, I tell stories about, let's say, an inspiration, whether it's based in India or a book or an art or music. But also, I tell a story about the culture, the causes that's affecting me, and the human issues. And also bring into highlight the people behind the scenes, you know, because the fashion industry is run by women, the minorities like LGBTQ members, you know, immigrants, and, you know, so it's an industry that is, like, so rich in culture and experience. So, like, for me, as I said, the commerce and art, there's a fine line of demarcation between them. So to walk that fine line is always a challenge. And sometimes you can do it, sometimes you can't, but my goodness, it has been the most exciting. I feel alive and I feel
grateful. Was it very swift for you throughout these 10 years, or was there some up or down for you?
Absolutely, there were ups and downs. So when I started my business in fall 2009, I was working at design director Bill Blass. I had a cushy job, amazing apartment, and all that stuff, everything was taken care of. And I decided to launch deep in recession when everyone told me not to do it. And so I moved from this massive apartment to a small studio in East Village, right in front of Hell's Angels. And I had savings there, and I invested that. It was like around $20,000 or $30,000. I invested in the collection, and I went on unemployment, and I went on a lot of dates, you know, and so that's how I survived. And so the starting in itself was challenging. It's like a self-finance company. I don't have investors. Yeah. I've grown it, like, strength by strength, slowly and gradually. You know, the challenges became about, that was initially the financial challenges. As the time went by, as the globalization and as the world changed, there were challenges about, you know, the climate crisis. There were challenges about like the political crisis that we all are facing. So it became, these are challenges, but these are life challenges. Like, it's normal challenges. So for me, it became about, like, really, all right, am I going to move forward with it? Am I going to face it and learn from it? Because one thing that I've always been driven by is I'm unafraid to say, I don't know. Help me learn. I'm the first person to say, I don't know. Can you help me? I'm always that. So I said that's the power of vulnerability.
And you've always spoken about your mother, how she's been an inspiration for you. So what all qualities did you take from her in this journey of 10 years?
Resilience, mainly. Resilience, empathy, gratitude, and also, like, immense sense of self-worth. You know, there's a fine line of demarcation between ego and self-worth, you know, and it can get, you know, blurred easily. But she gave me a sense of self-worth long back, and that to me has helped me a lot.
You've never shied away from making any political statement, be it on the ram with the kind of feminism and the feminist t-shirt that you came out with. So somewhere down the line, do you think that for a fashion brand, how important it is, like, to not just be a money-making business and also spread awareness or talk about issues for that matter? How important do you think it is?
I think it's important not just for a fashion brand, for all of us. We're living in a day and age where we all have followers. Even if you have an audience of one, it becomes a responsibility to speak up. Because at the end of the day, The absolute truth about our life is the impermanence of it. We all have to go, we all have to die, we have to leave this planet. What are we leaving behind? What is the legacy we leaving behind? What are the lives we have impacted positively? Those are important things to consider because, the reason why I speak up is, I know for centuries, all the decisions have been made with the patriarchy, right? You know, with all the men in the decision-making table, and look at where it has landed us, you know. And I think it is extremely, extremely important that we realize it now that the collective power of minorities and women coming together and making those sound decisions alongside with men who have been in the position of power, because that is the only way to move forward. And the reason why I speak up is I have the notoriety in some way or the other. I have like audience, I have followers, and I feel like as creative people, we are healers. You know, we are just not making clothes. What we are doing truly is bringing people into our lives through our clothes, through our music, through our models, through our sounds, through hair and makeup, bringing it all together to form a community where then we can heal. Hmm. And fashion has this immense, immense power to heal right now at this moment. And there's never been a more exciting moment for fashion to take the lead. Because when you see a plus size model, like, and I just looked at Ashley Graham pregnant on the cover of American Vogue, the first time, you know, like a plus size model in a single photo has a curvy model has been on the cover of American Vogue. It's a change, and a significant change that it happened, like it or not, for designers like us who, and you know, all these models who said, you know, they are also worth it.
Yeah.
And they spoke up. So I always feel like I am not afraid. I don't think anyone should be afraid of confrontation, because confrontation leads to discussion. Discussion leads to resolution. So that's what I think.
Yeah. In this day and age of social media and Instagram, where you see all these designers coming up with such amazing campaigns on Instagram, people seeing the first look of their collection on Instagram and social media, how relevant do you think ramp or runway is for that matter?
I think, you know, if you have to look at it like this, runway is a bigger platform for what, let's say, a small, you know, Instagram page is. Yeah. It is a platform, you know, it is a glamorous platform. It is a platform that everyone is excited. The beautiful thing about fashion is, here's the thing, everyone can be part of it. A woman in a village, you know, who may not know about me or any other designer, can still say, oh, what is she wearing?
Yeah.
You know, she has an opinion. She may not know about football. She may not know about cricket. She may not know about a lot of games or music, but she'll know about fashion because I would never wear it. That in itself is a participation, right?
So. Yeah.
I think it becomes an important factor that, you know, we engage, we are responsibly moving forward. And, you know, like, and I think it's important that as creative people, especially in right now in fashion, it becomes our immense responsibility that we speak up. That's the only way to move forward.
Okay. Your favorite Indian designer?
My favorite Indian designer?
Yeah.
Oh my God, there are so many of them.
Name
I would
one.
Say Abu Jani, Sandeep Khosla.
Yeah, you really love their
I
work.
I love their work. I've been a fan of their work for a long period of time. I love their work. I love, you know, Sabyasachi, Shantanu Nikhil. There's so many of them, you know. So I think it's an exciting time to be around.
Yeah, and when are we going to see your flagship store here in India?
I am, like, you know, literally, I lived in India. Like, India has been such a big part of my life.
Yeah.
The way I use color, the textures and everything, like, you know, it has become like, it has been the biggest influence. And so, and I also speak the language. I have friends here. So I've always, you know, I've realized in 10 years, I've created a unique position where I have notoriety or some kind of, you know, say in the Western world and also here now. So I want to be able to find a right partner to like launch something here. So let's see if that happens.
Okay. All right. It's lovely having you here.
Thank you
very
much.
Thank you so much for taking our time, Prabal.
Absolutely. Thank you.